Welcome back to The Morning Mindset. I hope you are ready to align your mind with the truth of God, because we have a whopper today. We have a great big truth of God that we need to get our arms around, and more importantly, get our hearts and our minds around. And that is that the difficulties we face in life, whether they be tragedies or accidents or health issues or relational struggles, though there may be a better path forward in all of those realms that God wants to bring about, the reality is that while we are in it, God is even using it for our good. He's using it, among other reasons, to push us toward a place of humility. He sees humility as being that important, that valuable in our lives. And I don't just pull this idea out of thin air. This is directly from the scriptures. When the apostle Paul had this thorn in the flesh, is what he called it, a thing that held him back, a thing he prayed, in fact, that God would remove from his life. So you know what that's like when you have some difficulty in your life and you're praying, you're begging, you're pleading with God to remove it from your life. It was that kind of thing for the apostle Paul. And he says he prayed three times and that God responded to him and said, "My grace is sufficient for you. So you don't need this thing gone. You just need my grace. And through that grace, my power will be perfected in your weakness." So he's basically saying, Paul, get used to having this in your life, because I've given it to you as a blessing, a channel through which my grace is going to come to you. And the way Paul came to see that was that this blessing of a difficult circumstance was given to him to keep him from exalting himself. That's Paul's own words as he describes how this manifested itself in his life. And the trial became a blessing in the weakness, in the humiliation that it brought, in all those things. The grace and strength of God could be better manifested. Now, as human beings, we don't understand that. We don't understand how a bad thing can be a better way for God to bring about his grace and help in our lives. We tend to want his grace to mean that all the bad things are wiped away. But that's not how God always does things. And part of this morning mindset is to help us align our minds with those kinds of truths, because that's very backwards from our culture and the way that we think of things. And so Paul's example is very instructional for us here, because he says he entered into what I guess you could say was a new stage in his relationship with God once he realized this trial, this difficulty, was for his good. Instead of just enduring it, instead of resenting it, instead of begrudging it, he chose to glory in it, to rejoice in the fact that it was in his life. He stopped asking for deliverance and took pleasure in it. He learned that the place of humility was a place of blessing, power, and joy. Those are the words of our author, Andrew Murray, from this book, Humility. Let me read it to you. He says, instead of asking for deliverance, he took pleasure in it. He had learned that the place of humiliation is the place of blessing, of power, of joy. That is entirely backwards to what we feel in our gut many days when those hard times are upon us, isn't it? In the moment, it doesn't feel very joyful or happy or blessed. I understand. I have been there. In fact, in many ways, I am there right now. There are difficulties that I face at times that in the moment don't feel like a blessing. So I'm not speaking to you out of some vacuum or from some high and holy place. I'm a brother on this path, just like you, and I understand. So was the Apostle Paul. And he's telling us when he was able to pull back the curtain and see what God was doing behind those difficult situations, he saw that they were for his good because they brought about humility in him. They put him in a right place of relation to his Creator. Oh God, make this true in us. Help us to embrace the hardships as means of your grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for telling others about the Morning Mindset. God bless you.